Thank you, Tori. We're here with Bret Mauser.
Mauser.
All right. So the city council spot has been vacated by Dante Acosta, who's now in the state assembly. And the city council is holding a special appointment for the city council seat, and there are now 50 applicants. Were you expecting 50 applicants?
No, not really. But at the same
neither
time,
are we.
You know, you never know what to expect for something like that. So.
All right. So, Bret, can you tell our listeners a little bit about yourself and who you are and what you do?
Sure. Well, for starters, my name is Bret Mauser. I'm 27 years old. I currently work for Southern California Edison as a service planner. I do technical electrical design and project management. We deal with, you know, utilities in the area, homeowners, new business, and the city of Santa Clarita as well. You know, I grew up here, actually. Went to Wiley Canyon Elementary School, Placerita Junior High, Hart High School, and COC. And I actually went to the University Center as well for my bachelor's degree from University of Laverne. As well as that, I grew up doing city softball, things like that. And most recently, I bought my first home about 2 years ago in Newhall. So
in your time here, have you done any volunteer work? Are you involved in any community organizations?
Well, aside from my involvement in the community with working for the local utility, I hold a volunteer board member position at my homeowners association, Del Prado. I've also done volunteer work for the Santa Clarita Marathon and for local elementary school talent shows and such. And I actually just signed up for the 2017 homeless count.
Oh. So if you were to be appointed to the city council, what would your main priorities be?
Well, I mean, I think we need to address some issues in town. For sure. I mean, it's obvious that traffic is a problem, and I could go on and talk about bottlenecked intersections and, you know, the traffic in general, but, you know, I actually wanted to shed light on a different topic, and that is the lack of interest in local government news and events by the younger generation, the upcoming generation. I mean, for example, with the last election that just happened, you know, I asked some of my peers and some people in their early 20s, you know, what were your opinions about the representatives that and initiatives that were on the ballot? And literally a response I got more than once was, oh, I just voted for that guy because his name sounded cool. And honestly, that is blatantly ignorant. And that's a problem, especially because voting age residents in town, you know, 18 and into their 20s, they hold a vast number of the population and a high voting power. So I feel like, you know, having a representative from that generation in the seat where they could, you know, we can generate more interest in that way, and that can lead to a relevant, educated presence in the voting community, and that can affect the city initiatives in a positive way, and we can move Santa Clarita forward in a, you know, towards the future and everything.
Mm-hmm. So have you seen something that the city council that you would agree with that you do is kind of similar, and then something that you might have done differently?
I mean, since the city was established, I mean, they've done a great job establishing our reputation here. I mean, in the LA Basin, we're something that's sought after. We're a safe community. People want to live here. I also love what they've done to downtown Newhall and Main Street here, encouraging new business and the new traffic pattern. I love that barbecue joint, by the way. It's really good. But I mean, at the same time, I mean, it's time for the younger generation to get involved and, you know, make a difference, basically. So,
okay. And is there one thing that you might have done differently if you were appointed to the council?
Well, my whole thing is, you know, this younger generation, upcoming generation, that's, you know, these decisions that are being made now are developing our community. And in 20 and 30 years, like, who's going to have to deal with the decisions that are being made to build the foundation now? It's us. It's you. And, you know, making a presence and having a diverse demographic as far as the decisions are concerned, you know, it can be proactive rather than reactive when the time comes when we're filling the council seats, the mayor, business owners, new, you know, educators, policemen. So it's something that, you know, at least should be considered. Mm-hmm. So.
All right. So you have about a minute left. Is there something that you want to leave our listeners with this afternoon?
I mean, as far as that goes, I just want to let the city council know that, you know, at least consider having somebody. I mean, I'm just a regular guy. I mean, I'm here. I put on my shoes just like everybody else, go to work in the morning. And, you know, I want to speak for the middle class working people and try to be a voice for a generation that I feel is underrepresented.
Well, thank you, Brett, for joining us today.
Thanks a lot.